First one is from Jonathan. I'm good at negotiating with strangers and building relationships with them. However, when it comes to negotiating with friends, I have trouble distinguishing the friendship from the negotiation we're trying to tackle. I think that sometimes it makes me more prone to settling with the deal quickly and not pushing things further since they're a friend. What's your advice?
Well, let me start with this. And this is tough, man. I've lost some friends in business because I didn't make that separation. Right. You know, we were working together. We were maybe partners or something like that. And we worked so closely together, but we were really close friends, you know, going into the business, which is why we got involved in it. And we let the business become our friendship. Right. We couldn't separate the two. And years later, we had to make a lot of work to kind of get some of that relationship back. But now I've learned way too late, honestly, because I've lost some really close friends, you know, over things that they weren't like hardcore. It was just more of like, man, business is going like this direction. We're so tired of kind of dealing with it together. Our friendship is the business right now, and we just need a break from each other and the business. So it kind of sucks. What I wish I had done, I wish on a regular basis I'd done a check-in to say, hey man, just to be clear, like I love you and I love our relationship and everything that we're doing, and I love our lives together. The business is the business. If it doesn't work, right, let's always know that we can step back. And I wish we had taken time to have those deliberate conversations about separating the two so that we didn't get the whole thing dragged in together, if that makes sense.
Yeah. And I think, you know, for me and my perspective on this, a lot of times we get so caught up in the short term gains and the wins and losses, we don't realize that over the long haul, there's probably a high likelihood that you're going to negotiate with this friend again. And he's going to remember that first negotiation where you pushed a little hard and you got that win and that notch under your belt. But now he's not willing to share his contacts with you. He's not willing to open up his network with you because you left that bad taste in his mouth. And I think, unfortunately, when we start tallying these wins and losses, and of course we listen to podcasts, we go, oh, I could have got a little bit more. I could have got that extra inch. We don't realize that that extra inch comes at a cost of feet and miles years from now on deals that are missed because that person doesn't want to work with you.
Well, and something else that we've talked about earlier, and this is especially when it comes to friends. And in our research and doing negotiation for the month, we certainly learned a lot about negotiation that certainly had helped us. And when I look back at some of these things, I know that there's been times in my life where someone says, oh, we need to go into a negotiation, or we're gonna have to talk about this. And if you haven't had much experience with it, your first tendency is to get nervous, to be on guard, and to go or either guns blasting or be extremely defensive, where we have learned that if everyone understands what's going on and we're all in to look for a win-win together, and that there's no time and that we're going to sit and we're going to figure this out, it's going to take some days, but we're going to enjoy this process and we're going to make sure that everyone leaves with what they with something they want here, then people don't have to freak out and get angry and play dirty pool. Think about it this way. If you're going into a fight in the street with somebody you know you can't win, your first move is to do something dirty to get an edge so you can walk out of that alive. And if you feel you're going into a negotiation that way where you have to hold back or play dirty so you can leave, that's not good for anybody. And I think if you don't have people who are educated on what negotiation really is and how it could be a win for everybody, well, then, of course, you're going to be nervous about dealing with friends in negotiation.
Yeah, I always say the same things. Negotiations are won by questions, not statements. If you're good at asking questions, if every point in the negotiation you're constantly asking, how do you feel about this? Why are you saying that? Why do you need that? Why would that work for you, et cetera? Then you're learning about the negotiation. If you're making statements, all you're doing is whittling down the conversation and the negotiation, and often sending the negotiation in the wrong direction because you didn't ask enough questions.